Lord be our brother JT. Hey man, I just checked out the video, man. I just had a chance to come back, and matter of fact, I didn't see the videos in the beginning when I first went there. I did a word nightcap, and when I went, and I didn't see the videos, and so when I went back for some, I went back to do something, I forget now exactly what it was. Now I saw you a couple video you had uploaded about a couple hours ago. I just wanted to come back, man, and just, kind of just say some things here on in response to what you were saying about, the sinful woman. And then, I'm so glad, man, that Jesus loves sinners. So glad. Because I know I was one of the chiefest ones. And I look over my life, I look back over my life, and I can see all the mess that I done. And the thing that I was caught up in, that wasn't right. And, but God, He saw fit that He didn't throw me away. And He picked me up and put my, and placed my feet on solid ground. Now, it's up to me to walk. It's up to me to walk. But I just look at Jesus didn't give up on me, and He doesn't give up on you. Neither does He give up on anyone. Mind you, I believe that there are some of us that leaves and gives up on God. But now, who am I to say, whom God is not using and whom God cannot save? And who am I to say that, like I said, I don't have a heaven or a hell to put anybody in. Many men don't have it. But I look at the life of Jesus, and everywhere that I can see where Jesus was dealing with people, He had compassion. The woman, the one you made reference to, this woman was a sinful woman. But if you notice, Jesus made a speech about this woman. He said, now, He told the people there, He said, now I came, you invited me, I came into your house, you didn't even offer me a cool glass of water. But this woman, she's not stopped. And not, she has not ceased from just adoring me. And the story goes about the alabaster box, and how Judas became indignant because he was a crook. But brother, all I can say is, man, people may not speak well of you, they may not speak well of me, and I don't know what's going on here, man. I got some issues. I got some issues with this thing, but God is not a man that He should lie, neither He's the Son of a man that He should repent. But whatever God say, He'll make it good, and He'll make it plain. In other words, He will bring it to pass. So the way Midi Man looked at thing is, when God saved me, He didn't lose His power to save. So why should I feel that I'm the only one that got it right? And that when God saved me, He broke the mold. He wasn't going to save nobody else. So when I look at people, when they're doing the different and various things, I look at it like this, bro. Everybody's not on the same level. I look at it like that. See, first of all, I feel that there'll come a time when you got to stop drinking milk and eat meat when it comes to the Word of God. In other words, the more you learn, the better you should be. That's natural, and matter of fact, in any aspect, any way you look at it, that's the way it should be. When you learn better, you should do better. And I feel like there are some things that I used to do years ago, and when the Lord delivered me, and as I stood and let Him renew my mind, I renew my mind through the washing and the regeneration of the Spirit, that there's some things that I should not be, it should be easier for me now than it was then. Now, I believe that. But when I look at the different, you got so many different, or you got so many diversities of people, and everybody's not the same. Some people got great strengths, some of us got great weaknesses, and you got a mixture of all kinds of people from one extreme to the other. And so Jesus deals with us individually. And matter of fact, the Holy Spirit knows all about us. He the one gave us our gifts and our abilities. He knows what's in us. And he's not going to ask anything of us that we cannot perform. Now, why don't we don't do something? I wish I knew. I wish I knew. Other than we know that the devil, our adversary, is busy. And he's seeking whom he may destroy. He goes about to and fro in and out of the earth to seek whom he may devour. He roared like a lion. He didn't say it was a lion. It was like he roaring like one. So with that being said, man, I'm just gonna bring it down to home. A lot of things, like I said, some things, man, as people do to you, it make you feel bad. And I used to get upset about it. But now, as I let mature, as I mature in Christ, I'm beginning to not worry less and less about what people do and how they do me. Because number one, it's not about me. In other words, it's not about me, the man. People are not going to treat you like you treat them most of the time. So we can't worry about that. But we just must walk the walk of faith. Let us run this race with fear and trembling. Let us do the will of God the best we know how. And then, like I said in my last video, I said, well, we need to know anything. Let us ask of God. God will lead us. Just be still. God will fight your battle. So I'm with you, man. Keep on proclaiming, man, the word of truth. People going to talk about you. They talked about Jesus. But we don't worry about that. You just go on and make sure you do what's right. Because we're living in these last days, man, and the sun is surely going down. And I feel like God is moving in this land. And I want to be a part of God's big scheme of things. I want to be part of it. Whatever part God wants me to play in it, I want to be able to play it. And I want to be able to run the race well. And that one day when I stand before him, he can say, well done, thou good and faithful servant. You've been faithful over a few things. You had your time, but you were faithful over a few things. He said, now therefore I'm going to make you ruler over men. And that's all I want to hear my Savior say, man. With that being said, this is Mighty Man saying peace. Goodbye.